We are joined by Franziska Althaus, ahead of Nationals Track and Field up in Allendale, Michigan. Franzi, you are competing in the 5K and the 10K in Nationals. When you found out that you qualified for both of these races, what was going through your mind?
I was really excited. I didn't expect that. Like, I knew I had to drop my PR by like 20 seconds to do so, and I didn't really expect that, so I was really happy I was able to do that.
Yeah, lowering the 5K time by 20 seconds, just remarkable. And you did it a couple of weeks ago at Lee on May 16th. Walk me through that race. Did you think, like, when you started the first mile or so, that you had it in you to maybe do something special?
Yeah, honestly, I did, because I felt great at the beginning. Like, I just stayed behind the pacemaker, and I felt quite relaxed, so I knew that was going to be a good race. So, yeah, as soon as she dropped out, I had to, like, keep pushing, and I did.
And you didn't feel, like, any cramps at all? You felt very smooth the entire way? Nothing was hurting, or were you battling through some maybe slight pain at all?
I mean, it's a race. A race is always going to be hard, so it was hard at the end, but that's just how it is.
What have the last few days been like training-wise leading up to your races this weekend?
So last week was really good. We had some good workouts. Yeah, so I'm excited. I know I'm in good shape and I can do it.
Did you have like a specific mileage total you had to do last week before your races this weekend, or was it?
So now we're lowering mileage because I want to be further and relaxed. But before that, I did like 75 to 80 miles in average.
A week?
Yeah.
What's it been like working with Coach Paul, Coach Matt? What have they been telling you, and how have they kind of supported you through this process getting ready for two massive races?
It's been really good. They're always like telling me that what I'm capable of doing, so that I can believe in myself. I mean, you have to be mentally strong and have to know what you're capable of to do so. So yeah, they're really helping me, not only like running wise become faster, but also becoming mentally stronger.
How do you become mentally stronger?
that's a good question. I mean, one thing is you have to believe in yourself. You have to know what you can do. And then, yeah, just like what you have to build over a longer time, you can't just get it from today to tomorrow.
And you were telling me the preparation for a 5K and a 10K is essentially the same, right? It's just when you run a longer race, you've got to do what essentially to succeed in a longer race?
Oh, you have to be mentally strong. You have to be prepared that it's going to be hard at the end, or that, like, in the middle you feel tired, but you still have to keep pushing and, like, tell yourself that it's not that hard now, but, like, it will get hard at the end, and then you just have to stay at that pace.
This is your first appearance in Nationals for outdoor track and field. You went to Sacramento for cross country prior, but when you stepped on campus, did you envision that you would ever run in Nationals at 5K and a 10K? Did you think that you'd ever get to this point? Do you have that confidence?
That was the goal, but like then a lot of girls went crazy fast times this year, so I wasn't sure if I could make it in the 5K, so I'm happy that I did, but at the beginning of the season, that was definitely my goal, to make it in both distances.
And training in the fall, I remember Coach Paul was telling me you actually didn't get to campus until the spring. So what was it like? I'm sure Zoom helped being able to be in contact with them, but what was it like training away from campus in the fall?
It was different. So I stayed at home because of COVID, and like I think it was a good decision because I needed to take care of my health. I didn't want to get COVID, and like there were no races here, and I had some races at home. And, like, yeah, I was always in contact with the coaches, so they messaged me a plan. It was slightly different, but it was pretty similar. So, yeah, we were in good contact, so and that really worked well.
And lastly, we talked about this before we started recording, but what would you say is the biggest difference about yourself as a runner from when you got here to right now in this moment?
I think I got mentally stronger. So, yeah. And well, before I came here, I wasn't, I don't know.
Not as mentally strong, you think?
I mean, I didn't know what I was able to do. I was more of weight before races. I was like, am I able to do this? Am I not able? Like, so yeah, now I go in the race and I know I can do it.
That's awesome. Well, good luck in Michigan, Franzi. We'll be certainly following you and Venetia as you all will hopefully do very well this weekend. So best of luck to you all.
Thank you.